Hey everyone, I'm Jenny from the channel This Story Ain't Over.
I'm Cindy from the YouTube channel With Cindy.
And hey, I'm Christine from Pulmonized Books.
I will be reacting to exclusive clips
from Netflix's Shadow in Bone series.
As you can tell, I'm incredibly excited.
For me, the thing that I really don't want the adaptation to mess up is the dynamic between the crows.
And if they're gonna live up to the idea that all of us have in our heads.
The fan base for the Grisha trilogy is scarier than the fold itself.
Netflix, please don't mess this up. Okay, I already love just like the whole setup here. You can see the different cultures coming together in Ketterdam. And here comes the gambling tables. Jesper's on the way. I'm just so excited.
Hey, you take Zimbi coin, yes?
Let me see that.
Aw, Jesper.
The Lucky Nine Casino at the block has had trouble with counterfeit coin lately.
His accent kind of reminds me of Pirates of the Caribbean. And I really dig that.
Oh my God, like Jesper's like entrance was just perfect. And he's just so playful like he is in the books.
So dramatic already, I love it. Kaz is Kane.
That Kane is famous. The first time we see Kaz in Six of Crows, I believe I just saw him beating somebody with that cane.
No loud noises at the table, Jesper. You scare off the pigeons.
Would one love us?
I'm wondering what the state of their friendship is at the moment. Like, does he just see Kaz as his boss where they don't even know each other that well yet?
Someone stole a decapel from a merch's private residence last night.
Why does this concern me?
Kaz is such a little bitch to everyone, which is accurate to the books. So good job, Netflix.
Oh, he's taking off his gloves. Oh my God.
Kaz has this whole thing about wearing gloves and has a really traumatic past.
I'm curious to see if we're gonna see any flashbacks, preferably any flashbacks that make me cry.
And Inej is gonna be there. Oh my God, she's so perfect.
Oh my God.
Hello, Inej.
My queen.
What information do you have for me tonight?
A lead on a job.
Oh my God, I've like envisioned this scene in my head 1,000 times. Inej popping out of the darkness behind Kaz and him just reacting very casually because that is their relationship.
He's looking for a crew willing to cross the fold into East Ravka and bring back something.
The fold.
Are they gonna get Alina?
Well, of course, certain death pays a million.
I feel like she has the looks down, she has the voice down. The actress really did a good job of embodying her character.
Kaz. I got this lead from one of the girls at the menagerie.
And then there comes Inej's like determined look, you know, advocating for people who don't have the ability to do that for themselves. Like she's just such a good soul and I love her.
She isn't like you. No one is.
Oh my God, that's such a Kaz thing.
Not Kaz being like, you're not like other girls.
If we're gonna survive a round trip through the fold, we'll need a miracle or two.
That was insane. Oh my God.
I can't believe they're gonna go to Ravka. Like, I can't believe they're in this to go get Alina.
I guarantee you, when the show comes out, there's gonna be so much discourse and so much arguing about Team Mal versus Team Darkling.
I will fight anyone who doesn't like Mal and Alina.
I do not ship Alina and Mal.
Me trying to consume the Mal and Alina ship.
Whoa, slow down.
He's like, slow down your thirst.
Mal being a tracker is just a really big part of his character. Not only that, it's like Alina has always been his North Star.
Oi.
Where have you been?
Oh, I love their bickering already. I think they already do a good job of childhood friends.
You couldn't even be bothered to reply to a single one of my letters.
I never had a word from you and I wrote to you nearly every single day.
Pack it up, the notebook.
He's got that angsty feel that I always pictured Mal to have.
They would have taken me away.
To a palace, Alina.
They would have split us up.
Netflix is doing a good job in kind of showing the appeal of this relationship and why it's so sweet and why it matters.
You wrote me a letter.
Yeah, he did.
Thank you for finding me.
I will always find you.
Always.
I knew it! I knew he was gonna say that. Mal is the kind of boyfriend who has to carry all the backpack and heavy stuff while you can just go wherever you want. Well, I love that for him.
I know that voice.
What voice?
the voice you use when you're not fine.
I absolutely love the way Jessie Maylee is playing Alina.
You can feel that they've known each other for a long time, but you don't have that like sizzly tension between them. It's more like this undertone of love.
Give me a hand.
Oh, she's gonna warm him up with her powers. Nice.
Alina has been in love with Mal for so long, and now he's really seeing her in her full form.
I'm sorry. It took me this long to see you, Alina. I see you now.
I'm not shipping them, but that was a nice little scene. It matches my expectation. Like, this is how I always felt about them. Of course I shipped her with the Darkling because he was so interesting.
I didn't really care for the Darkling. He just seemed like, you know, dusty, musty, crusty to me.
What do you see?
Someone's version of me.
Or perhaps the real you has finally emerged.
He's helping Alina understand these powers that have come out of nowhere, really.
You go into it not really knowing too much about him, and you are just slowly sucked into the mystery and just the way that he seems to have all the answers for Alina.
I don't know, he's playing it so well. Like, who wouldn't believe him?
Is your room satisfactory?
Well, I've never had warming stones put in my bed before.
He definitely is doing a good job of being her ally, being someone that she can turn to for help.
When I was a boy, I used to run away and hide here. Once I realized that I was a descendant of the most hated Grisha in Ravka.
It's so fun to watch him play it, how he's been victimized.
This is his story, isn't it?
You know it just from these old pictures?
Of course. Every child learns a history, not just Grisha.
And I love how he just tries to make himself seem so unintimidating in front of her, like when they're alone, to give her that sense of security. And it's just fantastic.
But he failed. He created the Fold instead and was killed by it, along with countless others.
I know this is necessary exposition to show the world building, but now he just looks like a history teacher.
I have devoted my life to undoing the great sin of my forebearer.
I know all the lies that the Darkling is telling, and I'm not falling for all of the things that I fell for at the beginning. So it's just really exciting to kind of see it in a new light, but also still falling for Ben Barnes's beautiful voice.
Only if I fail, they'll turn on me. And I'll be the brand new heretic.
It is gonna hit so hard when we get to a point of no return with him. I am excited to watch it play out.
I should be right by your side. You and I are going to change the world.
That was a panty dropping line. You and I are going to change the world.
I know all of this is a manipulation, but I still love it.
I think people can ship whoever they want to ship.
You don't read a lot of YA novels where the protagonist is potentially going to be in a relationship with the villainous character. So I'm really glad that string is woven through it.
It's different. She looks fantastic.
Ivan, my kefta.
I wonder if it's gonna show like how much she's changed, how much she's not like herself, how he's converting her to the Darkling ship.
I hear you were able to focus and split light without the gloves.
He's already subtly inceptioned himself into her mind.
In case of nerves.
They're already standing too close.
None.
They've gotten comfortable. Perfect.
But I'm
okay. I was so worried she was gonna initiate the kiss. I think he's gonna initiate the kiss. Is he? I don't know. Oh.
I just love like the body language of the scene as well.
Like how he always just has this mask face where he's not showing much emotion at all.
But it also kind of speaks to the way that she's kind of talking about her insecurities away from him, like looking away from him.
That we can offer Grisha and Ravkin's hope.
That means a lot to me. You mean a lot.
He is lying.
To everyone.
Ooh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Is she gonna kiss him?
She initiated that.
Alina.
He stayed in his place.
I'm into
it. I can see that.
What about Mal?
She's just wrapped up into him.
Keep going.
Big change. I see where we're going with this. And I like it.
I can already hear the screams in the distance of the Darkling shippers.
I mean, it makes the Darkling feel like even more of a master manipulator. Jenya is this kind presence.
And she's trying to help Alina out.
Huh? Have you ever bathed?
Jenya's like, girl, you stink.
This is gonna take more work than I expected. Fetch my kit.
I love the entire setup. It's just like so fancy and exactly what you expect of the palace.
In an hour, you'll be presented to King Piotr.
I'm to meet the king.
In an hour.
Oh.
Yes. Oh.
She's a little bit more composed and demure than I imagined Jenya, but I think it really works for her personality and, you know, the way that we get to see her in the later books.
I scald by making her eyes less shoe, Miss Seffin.
Oh, I love that they worked in Alina's shoe heritage.
I actually think it's refreshing to see a Western fantasy that shows Asians prominently in it and shows those microaggressions and racism that Asians face.
Don't change my eyes.
I don't care that you're part shoe. I care that you look terrible.
She's like, girl, your face is broke. Let me clean it up for you.
I am a tailor. I can fix. But I can also modify.
Oh, it's so different, like, seeing the powers work on screen.
It would be so nice if there were actually people who could do this. Whoop! All better.
She kept the scar on her hand.
That one's a reminder of home.
That hand probably held Mal.
It only lasts a few days.
That's a nice long time for your hair to look perfect.
I need more time. I've only been in Grecia for a day.
Maybe you've only been aware for a day. But you've been in Grecia your whole life.
Oh, I love that. Oh my God.
I really like Jenya.
The biggest thing that I think book fans will be debating is how the crows showing up in this story is gonna change the direction of the three book arc that we already know.
And it's one thing to have the characters in your head as you're reading and imagining them a certain way, but it's just totally different seeing them on screen.
This is gonna be like a really solid adaptation that even people who haven't read the books might enjoy as well.
And from what I've seen so far, I don't think Netflix has messed this up.
If you believe anything, believe I will not let that happen.
Shadow and Bone
is now streaming on Netflix.
Go watch it.